darling. And a little late, yes, it will feel hollow late. Oh boy, you're welcome. I said you're welcome. You're welcome, boy. Yes, you're welcome. Yes, a little bit of coffee and a little milk, it will go down smooth as silk. Ooh boy, you're welcome. I said you're welcome.
Hey,
you're welcome, boy. Woo! Yeah, you're welcome.
Okay, Kayla.
Huh?
What was, what do you think is the most meaningful part of the trip?
The most meaningful part of the trip? All the people I was with, all the information I've learned, and being able to drive to Alabama instead of flying, because driving is cooler than flying.
What would you tell to any prospective students about what to expect on this trip?
Be adaptable and flexible, because things can change. Not every trip is perfect, but that's what makes the trip more meaningful, honestly. It's when mishaps happen and things work out. It all works out in the end.
What was your favorite part of the trip?
Being with you all and being able to see new things.
What would you tell about any student who is looking to go on an alternative spring break trip?
Stay open-minded. And unfortunately, you can't get a crew like us. But stay open-minded and just enjoy yourself. It's worth it.
Catalina Catalan, and I'm currently a junior, and my major is justice studies. The reason why I decided to go on this trip was because my sophomore year I actually transferred to NEIU, and since I was, because of COVID and online classes, I wasn't able to actually participate as much as I wanted to on campus. And this trip, I thought it would be a great opportunity to get to know more people and interact with others. One of my favorite parts of this trip was overall just getting to know everyone. At first, I thought it was going to be really uncomfortable just because I didn't know anyone. It was my first time kind of traveling somewhere without family or friends that I knew. But overall, I had a great time. Everyone was very nice. We got to know each other right away from the get-go. And the time we were in car wasn't even uncomfortable. Overall, I felt like I was with my family. I would tell students just to go for it. Like, if you are having questions or if you're worried because you might be uncomfortable or it's getting out of your comfort zones, I would just tell you to take the chance, and it would be a great opportunity for you to go. I personally enjoyed it, and I think you would have a great time.
When I die, Lord, bury me deep, way down on Old Chestnut Street. I can hear home now.
My name is Andy. Why do I come on this trip? I came on this trip to challenge myself, learn about something outside my comfort zone. What's my name? So I'm part of the bachelor's degree in interdisciplinary studies. But I want to go into writing grants for nonprofit agencies. My favorite part of the trip is bonding with my classmates. I'm an older student, and I never felt part of the community at any college. So this helped. You know, this is good for the soul and for everybody, not just you. So I think it's a lifelong experience that that I'll keep.
Let me be there playing with you. Well, you won't have to go. Well, you won't have to go. You can get what you want on right here in my liquor store. You got a little wish.
Hi, I'm Cliff Arnault. I'm a senior at Northeastern Illinois University studying history.
Is he sleeping?
No, he's awake.
He's awake.
Come on. What was your favorite part of the trip?
My favorite part of the trip was meeting all of you and the other caravan that's ahead of us, and getting to understand the community goals and how to continue that effort. That was a bad one. I gotta redo that.
You're very loud.
Here, we can we'll go with this
I'm
one.
I'm not ready for this. Sweating now.
That's how I felt.
What would you tell to any student who's looking to come on an alternative spring break trip?
I would say that it's not just a spring break trip. It is the opportunity to get involved in a local community and help promote that community and understand local residential needs.
Okay.
My name is Frances. I'm a junior and a social work major. I chose to come on this trip because I wanted to be able to visit a new city that's rich in history, as well as get to know more people at NEIU. One thing that I learned on this trip, I learned about myself, is that there are a lot of areas where I can continue to learn and improve, as well as, I learned a lot about my teammates on this trip, and honestly, that was one of my favorite parts about this trip. One thing I would tell a future student who is planning to apply is to go for it. It's such an unforgettable experience, and it will exceed your expectations. Honestly, it's an amazing opportunity to get to know other students and other staff members at NEIU, and you won't regret it.
Major and a junior. The reason why I wanted to come on this trip was to get different perspectives on life and on Selma. What I learned about this trip was how privileged I am to live in Chicago, because after seeing Selma and the work that we've been doing, I feel like I need to be more grateful. And what I would tell a student at NEIU is to be more confident and join the ASB trip if you have the chance, because it will broaden your perspectives and it might be more fun than you think.
This girl is on fire. She's walking on fire.
My name is Jacqueline Roberts. I am a major in early childhood education. One of the reasons why I decided to come on this trip would be to learn more about our history and how it has impacted our present and future life ahead of us. One thing that I learned would be that starting a small difference is a very powerful move in a community. A lot of times we step up and be a leader and just kind of really consider a lot of the things that are going on around us. And what's one thing I would tell a student would be to take this opportunity, because this was a great learning experience for myself to hear somebody share their story with me and to inspire me to do better and kind of become a better leader person in my community. Has been a great experience.
Oh, Jesus had to walk that lonesome valley.
My name is Angelica, and I'm a junior at Northeastern Illinois. My major is social work. And the reason why I wanted to come on this trip is to learn more about the history. So, one thing that I learned from this trip was more about myself, not just the history. This trip has made me come closer to everyone, and I usually don't open up until like 2 weeks. One thing that I would tell other students if they had the opportunity to go on this trip is to take it, because a lot of times we just do schoolwork and we don't really get to experience the whole college life.
When you got to walk, it's for yourself. It's nobody here.
My name is Ryland. I'm a senior. I'm a communications, media, and theater student, minoring in journalism. My favorite thing about this trip was not just learning about the different kind of practices or training, such as restorative justice or the racial equity training, or even food equity, you know, and learning how to build a community garden or implement a community garden, but probably just learning about and getting to know each of the different members that went on the trip. Before the trip, I had not known any of them, and this really enlightens you as to their character. One thing I would say to a prospective student is to definitely consider going on one of these trips. It is not a typical spring break in any means. You're not going to go up and, you know, go to some party city or do anything of that sort, but this is something like totally rewarding. You're gonna remember for a lifetime. I hope. With one thing we did was pack nearly 200 boxes of food for the local community, and that's something that I'd never done before this. So feeding 200 families is incredible, and just the relationships that you kind of establish in 1 week are really astounding.
Come shake your hand, tell your father goodbye.